Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fine. Let us start our new topic today, which is very easy and interesting. Students, you have to clear your concept. No need to cram your answer. Write down your answer in your proper manner. So today I'm going to teach you a new topic, Battle of Plassey. So that will ask as a detailed question. So for 3 marks in the textual exercise question number 2, in that the first one, Battle of Plassey. Okay, so students, you have to write it down, this all clear properly, Battle of Plassey. So Sirajuddin was ruling over Bengal. He was the Nawab of Bengal. Sirajuddin was having impulsive nature. Impulsive means act without thinking. Without thinking, he was doing the act. Okay, he had many opponents in his states. Opponents means enemies. Opponents means enemies. During this period, British East India Company built a fortress. Fortress students means what? In the earlier era, British India East India Company and the kings and the Nawab built the fort. Fort means killa. Okay, around the trade center in Kolkata on pretext of security reasons. Pretext matlab bahana, security reasons, on the pretext of security reasons, without taking the permission of Nawab. Simply, British East India Company built the fortress. Fortress matlab killa. Okay, on the pretext of security reason, without taking the permission of Sirajuddin. And Sirajuddin was having impulsive nature, and Sirajuddin destroyed the fortress. When this news reached to Madras, a small army of the company led by Robert Clive reached Bengal in order to help the Kolkata trade center. Robert Clive reached to Bengal to solve this situation, everything, and to save, to help the Kolkata trade center. In spite of the army of East India Company being strong, they realized that it was not easy to defeat Nawab's army. Though the army was very strong at that time, but they realized that Sirajuddin was very strong ruler. It was not easy to defeat him. So they plan a game. They resorted to treachery. Treachery means a game, shadyantra, dhokha dena. Resorted means so bad. A conspiracy means shadyantra was planned in order to defeat the Nawab, in which the Nawab's commander in chief Mir Zafar and Seth Amichan were coaxed to join. Cox matlab say something to join with British East India Company's army, and Cox matlab fuslana, something said, something that Mir Jafar said, Amijan, that join Robert Clive's army on the pretext that Nawab is unnecessarily harassing the people of war declare at the ground near the village named Plassey. Okay, according to the plan, Mir Jafar lost the battle and Sirajuddin was defeated because Mir Jafar was coaxed to join Robert Clive. Mir Jafar was in the side of the Robert Clive. So he defeated the battle and Sirajuddin was defeated. Due to the Robert Clive's treachery, the Battle of Plassey ended in the half of the day. Due to the Robert Clive's treachery, treachery matlab shadyantra, the Battle of Plassey ended in the just half of the day. The company has got a free hold over 24 parganas. Now 24 parganas means what? It's a district, is a former district of Indian state of West Bengal. 24 parganas. Mir Jafar was made the Nawab of Bengal, and the foundation of companies rule in India was laid in the Battle of Plassey, 1757. I hope you all follow the topic properly, students. Clear? Mir Jafar set a mission for Cox to join. Okay. And the battle that Siraj ud-Daulah was defeated, okay, in the just half of the day due to the Robert Clive's treachery, conspiracy, mean shadyantra. This will ask for 3 marks, students, so prepare it. Now, students, Battle of Buxar. This also will ask for 3 marks, so you have to write it down, explain or write a short notes on Battle of Buxar. The Britishers made Mir Jafar and Nawab of Bengal under the different pretext. Try to extract, means pull out, a plenty of wealth from him. Due to their greed means lalaj, to gain more and more powers, the East India Company managed to dethrone Mir Jafar and made Mir Qasim the Nawab of Bengal. Dethrone means remove from the Nawab's post. And made Mir Qasim as a Nawab of Bengal. Mir Qasim proved to be more ambitious as compared to Mir Jafar. So there became the threat for the company. So again Mir Qasim was removed from, and Mir Jafar again made the Nawab by the Britishers. Now Mir Qasim took refuge, means protection, with the Nawab of Awadh. And during this time, the Mughal Emperor Shah Alam had come to Awadh. So three of them decided to join hands and fight the company unitedly and thus declare a war. Once again, Britishers made the Mir Jafar commander of chief of Siraj ud-Daulah's this army, Nawab of Bengal. Okay, and they try to extract, means pull out, the plenty of wealth, okay, from him. So they, in order to gain more and more powers, they remove Mir Jafar and made Mir Qasim as a Nawab. But Mir Qasim proved to be more ambitious as compared to Mir Jafar. So Britisher again removed Mir Qasim and made Mir Jafar Nawab. Now Mir Qasim, okay, took the refuge with Nawab of Awadh, and Awadh and the Mughal Emperor Shah Alam had come to Awadh. So three of them decided to join hands and fight the company unitedly and thus declare the war. At Buxar, East India Company fought against the united army, Mir Jafar, Nawab of Awadh and Shah Alam. Okay. That date you have to remember, 22nd October 1764, in which the United Army lost, and thus the company got the Diwani rights, means collection of the revenue, right to collect the revenue, that considered as the Diwani rights to Bengal, Bihar and Orissa. In this way, the East India Company's rule expanded. They got control over the, they started their foundation from the Battle of Plassey and Buxar. The English government passed a regulating act in 1773 AD. Underline for this MCQ, filling the blanks. According to which, Governor of Bengal was made the Governor General, and the trade and political activities of the company were brought under his direct control. The Mumbai Madras Governor Council was brought under him. Now you underline this for MCQ. Warren Hastings became the first Governor General of India. Underline this for MCQ Phillips. The British East Government passed the Regulating Act 1773 AD. The first Governor General of India, Warren Hastings. During his tenure, matlab time period, the first Maratha War and the second Mysore War with Hyder Ali of Mysore was wag means fought. The problem of East India Company increased because it had to face both the powers simultaneously. Simultaneously means ek saath. They had to face both the powers simultaneously. After the Warren Hastings, Cornwallis took over. ओके बिकेम द गवर्नर जनरल. आफ्टर वॉरन हेस्टिंग्स कॉर्नवालिस बिकेम द गवर्नर जनरल. अंडरलाइन फॉर द एमसीक्यू. ड्यूरिंग हिज टेन्यूर द थर्ड मैसूर वॉर टूक प्लेस विद द टीपू सुल्तान. एंड टीपू सुल्तान वॉज फेमस नोन एज अ टाइगर ऑफ मैसूर. ओके सो दैट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. थर्ड मैसूर वॉर फॉट बिटवीन टीपू सुल्तान एंड कॉर्नवालिस. ओके द कंपनी हैड टू जॉइन द हैंड्स विथ मराठा एंड द निजाम टू डिफीट टीपू सुल्तान. एंड टीपू कुड नॉट विन अगेंस्ट द कंबाइंड फोर्सेज एंड हैड टू एक्सेप्ट द ट्रीटी. So here the expansion of the company rule. Students, you have to go through the MCQ and objective type of question answers, like the company has passed Regulating Act in 1773 AD. Warren Hastings become the first Governor General of India. Okay, during his time, the first Maratha, second Mysore war fought with the Hyder Ali. Clear. After the Warren Hastings, Cornwallis become a Governor General. He fought the third Mysore war with the Tipu Sultan, who was known as Tiger of Mysore. The company had joined hands with the Nizam of Hyderabad and Maratha, and Tipu Sultan defeated the battle. Okay. After the Cornwallis, Sir John Shore became the Governor General. Warren Hastings, then Cornwallis, then Sir John Shore. That you have to remember. But Sir John Shore was having very rigid policies. So East India Company's fame started declining. Rigid means no need to change. And Marathas become stronger. So Governor General Wellesley, who came after John Shore, got the responsibility of making the company supreme in India. So after Sir John Shore, okay, General Wellesley came. And he had decided to make East India Company supreme, means at the topmost position in India. So for this, Wellesley introduced subsidiary alliance system. Students, you have to remember this. Lord Wellesley, Governor General Wellesley had introduced a subsidiary alliance system. So students, you have a question and this is very important. You have to learn it. What are the question number 1-3? What are the important terms and condition of subsidiary alliance policy? In the yellow box, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points are given to you students. That all the points you have to learn and you have to write it down. Who introduced subsidiary alliance policy? A system, Lord Wellesley introduced a subsidiary alliance system or policies, okay, in order to expand the East India Company. So first point, terms and certain condition they put forward, okay, those the state or the king, those who accepting such a system, so they will providing such type of facilities to them. The army train by East India Company government will be provided to the state that accept the system. Simply, the state or the king or the Nawab, those who accepted the subsidiary alliance system, Britishers will give them army. Trained army with a group of soldier and equipment and the arms and all. In return, the Nawab and king, what they had to give. In the state accepting the system will provide the army or give away provinces with equal income to the British. They had to give the province or the equivalent income to the Britishers. Province means you know the provinces with equivalent income to the British. Next. Without the permission of the Britishers or the East India Company, the state will not wake, means fought war, or sign the treaty with the other states. The king and the Nawab, without the permission of the Britishers will not fought any war. There will be one English representative in the state assembly. State assembly, you know, the king and the nawab having the gems and all, like, you know, Akbar having 9 gems, that considered as state assembly. So one English representative should be there in the state assembly, the king and the nawab who accept such system. Other foreigners not to be employed in the state. Other foreigners means no Portuguese, okay, no Dutch, no other foreigners apart from the Britishers to be employed in the state. Students, you have to remember this, the states and the rulers who accepted the subsidiary alliance system. Nizam of Hyderabad first accepted the subsidiary alliance system, then Mysore, then Awadh, then Gayakwad, then Sindhya, then Slay, and then Holkar accepted the subsidiary alliance system. Student, subsidiary alliance system. Subsidiary alliance system was also considered as a sweet poison. This system was like a sweet poison. So you have to remember this. Clear? Governor General Wellesley introduced subsidiary alliance system and was considered as sweet poison. By implementing this system, Wellesley annexed many provinces and expanded the rule of East India Company. Governor General Wellesley asked Tipu Sultan also to accept the system, but Tipu Sultan refused. For declining the alliance system, the company with support from Nizam attacked Mysore in 1799. And during this fourth Mysore war, Tipu Sultan lost his life and fight against the British rule. So, Wellesley started sweet poison policy that considered as a subsidiary alliance policy. With the help of the subsidiary alliance policy, NX joined many provinces and expanded the East India Company. Wellesley told Tipu Sultan to accept it, but Tipu Sultan refused it. So with the help of the Nizam, Wellesley fought the war, okay, against the Tipu Sultan in 1799. And during the fourth Mysore War, Tipu Sultan lost his life while fighting against the British. After the Wellesley, Hastings came to India as a governor of general. And he fought a war with the Nepal and made the Gurkhas, Nepali peoples, to join the armies. After the Wellesley, Hastings came to India as a governor general and he fought a war with Nepal and made Gurkhas to join his army. Hastings fought a battle with Pindaras and took control over them also. With the third Maratha war, the supremacy of the company was established. Now here, students, you have to remember, underline for the MCQs, William Bentinck, underline, Governor General William Bentinck is known as Liberal Governor General. Bentinck believed that dissatisfaction in the different states due to the imperialist policy adopted by the previous Governor General could not bring about any unity. And he was a very liberal in his deeds. Liberal means what? He is freedom lover. Liberal thinking personality. Okay. People of India dissatisfied because of the imperialist, such as stern policies adopted by the previous Governor General, like Wellesley, Sir John, all that. So he was a very liberal in his deed. Deed means work. Then you have to remember this, students. Dalhousie came to India as a Governor General in 1848. He was fierce, strong, imperialist. Dalhousie adopted the policy of annexation for the expansion of company rule and British imperialism in India. So students, you have to remember Dalhousie's policy of annexation, question number 1-4. These are three charts given to you. You have to do it. Annexation by war. Join the different provinces by fighting a war. Punjab, पैगू मीन्स लोअर बर्मा. एनेक्सेशन ड्यू टू द किंग टाइंग विदाउट हेयर, हेयर मतलब वारस. द किंग द किंग डिड नॉट हैव ओन सन, ओके दैट वारस. सतारा, जेतपुर, संबलपुर, उदयपुर, झांसी, फगत, देन नागपुर. एनेक्सेशन ऑन द प्रिटेक्स्ट ऑफ मिसमैनेजमेंट, प्रिटेक्स मतलब एक्सक्यूज. मिसमैनेजमेंट द कंडीशंस ऑफ द यू नो इनसाइड द दिस ऑल द किंग्स, किंग डिड नॉट मैनेजिंग एवरीथिंग प्रॉपरली, दैट्स मिसमैनेजमेंट. अवध. एनेक्सेशन ऑन प्रिटेक्स्ट ऑफ डेट कलेक्शन, ओके प्रिटेक्स मीन्स बहाना एंड डेट मतलब कर्जा, ओके तो निजाम्स प्रोविंस. एनेक्सेशन टू एंड द नेम सेक रूल, सिर्फ नाम से ही रूल चलता है कर्नाटक एंड तंजोर. दिस यू हैव टू रिमेंबर स्टूडेंट्स, डो नो नीड टू ड्रॉ द ट्री चार्ट्स, ओनली राइट इट आउट. एनेक्सेशन बाय वॉर, लिस्ट डाउन द प्रोविंसेस नेम. एनेक्सेशन ड्यू टू द किंग डाइंग विदाउट हेयर, लिस्ट डाउन द नेम्स. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 14, सॉरी क्वेश्चन नंबर 1-2. What reforms did Dalhousie bring about? So tick mark this. Okay, besides being an imperialist, Dalhousie was a reformist. Reform means the person who need to change everything. Reformist, sudharna karna. The first railway line in India between Mumbai to Thane in 1853. Wireless system between India and England. First railway started by Dalhousie. Wireless system between India and England started by Dalhousie. Public work department started by Dalhousie, and also English education started by Dalhousie. Dalhousie did many positive changes in India, were introduced in his tenure. Tenure means time period. He passed the laws to ban the child marriage, earlier child marriage, and advocated a what? Widow remarriage. So student, this paragraph you have to remember, this is very important. Question number 1-2, the Dalhousie's, they bring about the changes and the reforms. That's first railway line started by Dalhousie. You have to remember the year 1853. Okay, within 100 years of lifespan, that's of Battle of Plassey, 1757, the British rule and the empire both expanded. But in the process, they had to face many dissatisfaction of the Indian states. This was manifested in the form of the first struggle of independence, 1857 AD. Means you know that revolt of 1857. Okay, students, from these slides you have to remember Dalhousie's policies of annexation, positive reforms of Dalhousie, students. Okay, this will ask for 2 marks. Question number 1-2, what reforms did Dalhousie bring about? You have to remember Dalhousie started the first railway line between Mumbai to Thane in 1853 AD. He had started the wireless system between India and England. He established public work department and he started English education. He banned the child marriage and started widow remarriage. That you have to remember. And Dalhousie's policy of annexation, the tree charts given to you, that you have to remember, students.